Do you know what I like to do on Friday nights? I like to look at some baseball cards. Hey, I have a few really cool things to show you here. And I want to start off and show you some old exhibit cards and premiums that I had up on my walls that I took down, and I'm going to put them away with my others. But before I do that, I thought I'd show them to you. I don't think I've ever shown these on my channel. If I did, it was a long time ago. So first, and you know, this is what's awesome about the YouTube sports card community, because I couldn't remember what this premium was. And I reached out to Orlando and Sammy Thunder, and Sammy responded right away and led me to what it is. So it's a 1929-30 R315. And I had totally forgotten what this was. I haven't looked at it in a long time. And I'm not sure that we know where these come from. But anyway, it's a Bill Terry. And I just did a short on these. They're very thin and flimsy cards. Now, if he was a golfer, he'd be critiqued for finishing off his back foot. And this is an Al Lopez, and this is fabulous, too. But this, sorry, this is a Gaudi 1936 Gaudi wide pen premium. And so is this, Bill Dickey. So these are the wide pen, because you can see the wide pen signature there. And then this is the 2930 R315, and it lists the team down there, and you can see the name is in a box. So they're easy to tell apart, even though they are essentially the same paper, the same cardboard, same thinness, and look the same otherwise, really. Not sure if Gaudi made these or not. I don't know if anybody knows. You have any information on these, let me know. That's the, I believe that's the only one I have. And then I have this 1921 exhibit, Babe Adams. I got this 1962 Statback Willie Mays. They made these stats in black and in red. I have both versions of the Stan Musial. I might have both versions of the Hank Aaron. I don't know why I like to get both versions if I can. Man, I have a fantastic card right here. And I have a group of these. I just got these 180 point holders for the real thick memorabilia cards. You know, I hate the way they look in the top loaders. They just don't present too nicely. They're not so clear. So I got these, and they're very clear. And this is a new addition for me, and the other ones I just reholdered. But this is fabulous. This is a Serena Williams. It's numbered 3 out of 3. And it has a little black piece from her cat suit, I'm assuming. That's a fantastic card. I had to have that thing. And I reholdered this Pete Rose. This is fantastic. This is number 25. That red just pops with the black and white picture. Fancy borders there. And my man Tony Pena. I have an autograph here. It's a real thick card. And I got this back in the day. of my Pirates patches. There's McCutcheon, Gerrit Cole, Starling Marte, and Gong, who, man, had an amazing rookie season. Then he had like 82 DUIs, went back to Korea. He wasn't allowed back in the country. And then and then he came back and he didn't do so good. He made one more go-round, but he had an amazing rookie season. And then he shattered his leg. Anyway, that was a disappointment because I was a real big fan of his and got a bunch of his stuff. But some cool patches there. And I got another star card. This is Dr. J celebrating his five-time ABA All-Star. And I added another card for my 1972 Pro Star set. These were out of Canada. And I love these cards. I've been working on the set. Ken Singleton. All right, guys. I don't want to hear any more about Kenny Pickett. I'm depressed. I'm a fan of his, so... I'm sorry they drafted a young quarterback and didn't decide to stick with him. I can't have any more texts or anybody sending me anything more. Can't do it. That's it. I've been getting a lot of people asking me about my holders that I've been showing, and I just want to reiterate, they're Mag Pro holders sold by Zion Cases. Mag Pro. Because I've pointed them out in several videos, but people that haven't watched those videos keep asking me what they are. So they're Mag Pro, made by Zion Cases. I have an email address for a woman who will make you custom labels if you want that, and you can order them. And they're very affordable. They will mock up, give you several examples. They'll do mock-ups, and you can pick the one you want and order them. If you want that, reach out to me. I can give you her email address. So that's what I have for you. It's Friday night. I'm going to go hang out with my wife. Thanks for hanging out with me.